Nikon is known for not being the best camera for video.
Well, the 7500 anyway.
Yeah. That's better. Well, yeah, that was a nice spot. That's a nice way. That's a nice way to start a video, isn't it? Much needed, I can tell you. Anyway, this brings me on to a thought recently that I've had. Now, I went to see my two older brothers. They're not a lot older than me, but they both live. They've got no pets. They have no dogs, no cats. They live in immaculately clean and tidy dwellings, hermetically sealed with double glazing. The surfaces are all sterilised, and you know, it's so clean. Sometimes when I go there to visit them, I feel that. You know, I got to be careful where I tread, because you know I'm not that clean. I've got dogs at home. I come out into nature. I get my hands dirty. Anyway, my two brothers, older brothers, not that much older than me, have not been very well recently. And one of them is normally quite fit and healthy. And I was surprised he looked pale. He looked. Just a bit run down, really, and I think it's all to do with the fact that they're living in this clean, sterile environment. And this goes for a lot of people, and their immune system, is not getting a workout. Coming out into nature, getting your hands dirty, exposing your immune system to bugs, bacteria, parasites. I don't know. You know. Not very nice to think about. Anyway, to cut a long story short, I think our immune systems need this workout to keep us fit and healthy. There you go. Look. Anyway, the main reason for this video isn't that, though. It's my dear beloved Lumix G7 camera that I've had for five years now, or thereabouts, finally bit the dust. Hang on a sec. Phone call. Yeah, that was my friend Joe on the phone. He might be joining me later on in the woods for a photography expedition. But the reason for this is my Lumix G7 died over all the years I've had it. I think hot, going out in the cold, in the damp, eventually moisture gets in, and it wasn't a weather sealed camera. Finally, on my last camp, I was out in a heavy rain and it died. And so that was the end of that £500 camera. But as I say, I did get 5 years out of it, so I can't really complain, to be honest with you. But I find myself in a predicament. I don't want to spend another load of money on a camera just for video, when this year I've bought the drone. I've also bought the D7500, and the body only for that was £800. Then I spent another £800, another £1,000 on the lenses for it, and it's the D7500 is a brilliant photography camera, but apparently it's no good for video. And I thought, well, I'll try it. I think it will produce good video, but it's a faff in that you've got to manually focus, manually white balance. You can't flip the screen to look at yourself if you want to do any sort of vlogging style shots. So the main purpose of this video is to come into these woods, try it out, see what it's like, whilst I'm here, take some photographs, find some fungi, and just generally have a look around, and then go back home, look at the clips, see what they look like, put them up to see if they're any good. I'll post them, obviously, and you'll get to see them. and the D7500 will have to be my dual purpose photography camera and video camera, at least for the next few weeks, if not months, till I can afford to replace it. It's not that I'm broke, I can afford to replace it, but it would mean taking money away from ever needy areas of my life, should we say. For example, my pension fund and stuff like that. I don't want to touch that. So anyway, into the woods we go. See it, they're everywhere, there's loads of them. There's a fungi there, there's a puffball there. It's obviously shed a lot of its spores already. I think these ones are not the edible variety though, because I've seen these earlier in the season when they were growing, and I think they're a type known as the earth ball. There's another one just there. Yeah, they've all their spores are mostly gone there. They grow every year in this location next to this oak tree. Well, I thought I'd show you this clip of me setting the camera up. I've found a subject which is over there out of shot at the moment. You'll see it in a minute. So I set the camera up, turn on live view, make sure I'm in the shooting video. I've got the camera set to video. And this is the live view, and then I've got to find my subject. I've had to disable stabilization. I'm doing manual focus, so I then zoom in on my subject there, and then turn until I get a nice sharp image. And that's about as sharp as it's going to be. And that's my clip, and I press record and then do my piece to camera, which you'll see next. Press record. Right, this is an interesting fungi. It's beautiful and lovely. I grew up in the 60s, I was born in the early 60s and grew up in a rural area, and there were lots of mushrooms in the mushroom field. And we were told as kids, you can pick and eat the mushrooms, but you can't pick and eat the toadstools. So I had a good idea what a mushroom looked like from a very early age. And we used to pick them and eat them, take them home, cook them. And then as I got older, I started watching YouTube. And I've become more scared of taking mushrooms. Now this one here, I'm pretty sure this is a death cap, Amanita phalloides, I think its name is. And the reason why is I can see there's the remains of a veil where it was attached to the stem, the colour, the location where it's growing, and underneath there I can see a bulb. So I think this is potentially one of the most deadly fungi in the UK, if not the most deadliest fungi. But it is absolutely beautiful, and it's a lovely thing. So very worthy of a photograph, and then to be left alone to do its thing, whatever that is. It's in a symbiotic relationship, no doubt, with the forest. as you can see, Joe's turned up. He's taken a photograph of the death cap fungi. I was planning on making him a stew with the I wouldn't do that. But anyway, yeah, I just thought I'd show you this. This is the other lens I got for my camera. This is really expensive. I'm not kidding, I paid over £800 for this. It's a Sigma 18-35. Ridiculously heavy. But I thought I'd put it on the camera because over there there's some lovely fungi growing out of an old stump. So let's swap the lenses over and get close in on those. So here are those lovely fungi. Absolutely no idea what they are. They're growing on an old stump. This looks like it was an old oak. Not great diameter, so it didn't make a great age, but beautiful things. Almost fairy tale, aren't they? You can see my hand there for comparison.